A pleasant good day to everyone. We want to thank you for joining us, the Cura Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International. We want to let you know that we have been praying for you, your family, the nation, and the world at this very critical time. We want to encourage you at this time to send a message or call someone, inviting them to view this program and be ministered to. We now go into a time of praise and worship with the semi-worship team, thanking God for who He is, praising Him for the things that He has done.
Jesus is alive. Death has lost his victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He's alive.
Oh,
So break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. So break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
There is power,
there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Jesus, break every chain, 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 break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. Every strong hope shall be broken. You have the victor's crown. You overcome. You overcome. Every high thing must come down. Every strong hope shall be broken. You have the victor's crown. every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, 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 break every chain. Break every chain, 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 break every chain,
break every chain. Power in the name of Jesus. There is life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Father God, we worship you.
Our theme, Growing to Greatness, is guided by two portions of Scripture. Matthew 20, 25 to 28, which says, But Jesus called them unto him and said, Ye know that the princes of the Gentiles exercise dominion over them, and they that are great exercise authority upon them. But it shall not be so among you. But whosoever will be great among you, let him be your minister. And whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant. Even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister, and to give his life a ransom for many. And secondly, Romans 8, verses 9 to 11, which says, But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so, be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. We will now invite Reverend Dr. Melch Pope, our senior pastor, to share on this theme, Growing to Greatness.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Happy Resurrection Day to you. Oh, glory to God. What a wonderful God we serve. The God who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that works in us. That's right. I am talking about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He spoiled principalities and powers. He is alive and alive forevermore. This morning, I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus the Christ. I tell you, I become so excited about this. Yes, Christ is risen. Yes, he is risen indeed. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for connecting with us. Remember, later we're going to be having communion. So I want you to get your piece of bread. I want you also, or if you do not have bread, some biscuit. I also want you to get some grape juice. You know, let's not go down the road of the alcoholic, please. No, let's get it. Let's stay sober. Let's do that. Get some grape juice or close to it. You want to do that and prepare yourselves, because after the ministry of the word, we will be having communion together. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. As you know, the numbers are on the screen. You want to look, you want to call, you want to call for prayer. And I want to thank the many of you who continue to pray for us. thank you, and thank you for your ongoing support. You know what you're supposed to be doing. We appreciate it very, very much in these times. And let's seek to support one another in every way possible for the glory of Almighty God. Let's pray this morning. Thank you, Father, for the power of Jesus the Christ. Thank you for allowing him to come into this world. And this morning is a special morning for the Church of Jesus Christ. We bless your holy name today. Now use your word to bring about life and hope and strength, because we're talking about the risen Christ more than ever before. We know he's alive and alive forevermore. But thank you today for your grace upon our lives. Thank you for this blessed nation today, and for the privilege, the freedom to share the word of Almighty God. Blessed be his glorious name. Amen. Bless his holy name. I want to share with you this morning, of course, we're talking about the resurrection, but it's really resurrection living. It is one thing to talk about him historically, but we want to come to where the rubber meets the road. On Easter Sunday morning, I always seek to bring a quote. I'm excited about it. But let me read the text. Acts chapter 2, from verse number 31. Acts chapter 2, from verse number 31. He, seeing this before, spake of the resurrection of Christ, that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh did see corruption. This Jesus had God raised up, whereof we are all witnesses. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he hath shed forth this, which you now see and hear. For David is not ascended into the heavens, but he saith himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. Verse number 36 of Acts chapter 2. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made that same Jesus whom you have crucified both Lord and Christ. And then Philippians, the second chapter. Of course, we've been dealing with growing to greatness. Philippians, the second chapter, from the 9th verse. Philippians chapter 2, from verse number 9. Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should or must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. this book, Evidence That Demands a Verdict, by Josh McDowell, chapter 10, under the subject Hoax or History, speaking about the resurrection, is quoting from Michael Green in his book Man Alive, and I quote, "Christianity does not hold the resurrection to be one of among many tenets of belief. Without faith in the resurrection, there will be no Christianity at all. The Christian church would never have begun. The Jesus movement would have fizzled out like a damp squid with his execution. Christianity stands or falls with the truth of the resurrection. Once disprove it, and you have disposed of Christianity." He went on to quote, "Christianity is a historical religion. It claims that God has taken the risk of involving himself in human history, and the facts are there for you to examine with the utmost rigor. They will stand any amount of critical investigation." Paul says God had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. So let's get it now. Let's remind ourselves this morning. The historical accounts of his resurrection are very important. So we continue to remind ourselves. Matthew chapter 28 and verse 6. "He is risen." Mark chapter 16 and verse 6. "He is risen indeed." Luke chapter 24 and verse 6. The same thing is mentioned there. "He is risen." We're talking the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Then when we get to John chapter 20, we find not a verse 6 now, because we've been having Matthew 28, 6, Mark 16, 6, Luke 24, 6. We get to John chapter 20. I must give to you, there's not a verse 6 there that says he is risen, but you're going to find that in verse 9 and supported by verse number 17. However, what is even more important and a virtue is the transferring of this resurrection life and power in our daily living. Let me say this again. While the historical records are factual, and I want you to go through it with utmost rigor, I know it will stand the test of time. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, the book of Acts, which is a continuation of the Gospel of Luke. Read it. Put it to the test. It is going to stand. What is important is the transferring of this resurrection life in our daily living. You see, the resurrection is intended to give life. It is about life. It is about living. It is also about power. The Apostle Paul mentions in the book of Philippians, the 3rd chapter and the 10th verse, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death. He desired to know him and the power of his resurrection. In his power, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is about power. But it's not just about power. This power is intended, it is to cause us to change. But let me hasten to say, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is about change. Let me say this again. The resurrection of Jesus Christ is not just about power to work miracles. Great. In fact, we need it more than ever before. But it is about change. Yes, it is about change. Our world continues to look for answers. Our world continues to search for answers because they have a number of questions. I am glad this morning that the church can be of tremendous blessing to the world. In fact, Jesus said, I send you out into the world to be as wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Matthew the 10th chapter and the 16th verse. In fact, he said unto them, his disciples, while I am in the world, I am the light of the world. John chapter 9 and verse number 5. But let me hasten to say, he looked at his disciples one day and says, you are the light of the world. Matthew chapter 5, from the 14th verse unto the 16th. You are the salt of the earth. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 13. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify the Father who is in heaven. The Apostle Paul reminded the church at Philippi, Philippians the 2nd chapter from the 13th verse. After reminding them of working out their own salvation with fear and trembling, he said, it is God who works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. But prior to that, he says, do all things without murmurings and disputings, that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine forth as lights. Glory be to God. So the church has a critical role to play in assisting the world in answering their questions. I am glad that Jesus has given to us this mandate. Here's what he says to us in 1 Peter 2:9-10. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, that we should show forth the praises of Him who has called us out of darkness into His marvelous light, which in times past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which have not obtained mercy in the past, but now we have obtained mercy. So we need to share it. We need to let men and women know the resurrection of Jesus the Christ makes the difference. Glory be to God. So the world continues to search out. Let us be in that place where we could be of help to our hurting, lost, and dying world. Resurrection living, therefore, has to do with, first of all, a new beginning. Resurrection life. Jesus, on that third day when He rose again from the dead, He says, I am the first and I am the last. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the ending, the first and the last. I am He that liveth and was dead, and behold, I'm alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys of hell and of death. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. That will be found in Revelation, the first chapter, from the 8th verse. And you can go right down to the last verse of Revelation chapter 1. So resurrection life and resurrection living, because it is about change, it has to do with a new beginning. Remember John, or rather, remember Thomas in John, the 20th chapter, from the 24th verse, when the disciples said to him, listen, we have seen Jesus, and He is alive. And Thomas said, and listen, except I see for myself, I will not believe. Yes, but the Bible tells us, and He has a point, because He was not there when Jesus appeared on that resurrection morning. 8 days later, Jesus appeared, and the numbers are important in the scripture. 8 has to do with a new beginning. That's right, a new beginning. And that's what we're talking, resurrection life, a new beginning. 8 days later, Jesus appeared and He says to Thomas, you come. Trust your hand, go ahead into my palms and look at my side. And be not faithless, but believing. And the Bible tells us immediately Thomas genuflected, reverence went down. I believe he would have gone down on his knees and began to kiss the feet of Jesus. And, you know, Jesus said, listen, Thomas, because Thomas says, he says, my Lord and my God. And Jesus said to Thomas, He says, Thomas, because you've seen me, you believe. Blessed are they who have not seen and yet believe. John chapter 20 and verse number 29. But remember, Jesus, He did not stop there. He said, the Bible says, these things are written that you will believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and that believing on Him, you would have life through His name. The resurrection has to do with life and living a new beginning. 2 Corinthians 5 and 17 reminds us, therefore, if any man be in Christ, He's a new creation. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. You begin to see the world now through the eyes of our Savior and our Lord, Jesus Christ. Secondly, resurrection life, the transferring of the change and the power, has to do with a new identity. We're talking resurrection life. Christ in us. Galatians chapter 2 verses 20 and 21. The Apostle Paul, when he came into contact with this new life, this new beginning, he cried out, "I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me." He went on to say in verse number 21 of Galatians chapter 2, he says, "I do not frustrate the grace of God. For if righteousness comes by the law, then the debt of Christ is in vain." And we know that's not the case, because Christ became that person. Romans chapter 10 and verse 4, Christ becomes the end of the law for righteousness. He is the one who became sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Nothing good that we can do. People, yes, a new identity. Christ in me, the hope of glory. I am no longer a slave to sin. I am now a son, because the Spirit of God dwells in me. This is what the resurrection life has done. Romans 8:11. "For since the Spirit," if that same Spirit that dwells in Christ dwells in you, "then that Spirit shall quicken our mortal bodies by his Spirit who dwells in us." We did not receive the spirit of bondage again to be in fear, but he has given to us the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, "Abba, Father." So you see, he has delivered us from the power of darkness and transferred us now into the kingdom of the Son of his love. Glory be to God for Resurrection Sunday, for resurrection life. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Romans chapter 14 and verse number 17. Yes, resurrection life must be transferred in our daily living, giving us a new beginning, a new identity. I've got a father. Yes, I can come boldly to the throne of grace and obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 16. Resurrection life also should cause us to walk in newness of life. Romans chapter 6 verses 1 to 4. To cause, because just as Christ was raised from the dead, he no longer is flesh and blood, but flesh and bones. Glory be to God. The blood was shed for our sins, yours and for mine. It is already accepted by the Father. As I mentioned earlier, that's why we can come boldly to the throne of grace and obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. And I tell you, yes, we need him more than ever before. Glory be to God. He makes the promises available to us. The Bible makes it clear that all the promises of him are yea, in him are yea and amen. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse number 20. Newness of life. Walk in newness of life. Thank God for yesterday. Thank God for last month and last year. And we need to stop that shoulder and a coulda, shoulda, woulda, and if I coulda, woulda, and I should not have. Stop that. Here's what the Apostle Paul reminds of us in Philippians chapter 3, verses 13 and 14. He says, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are before us. He says, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. The past is gone, never to return. We are in the present, but we've got to keep looking. I want to say to us this morning, let's keep looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Hebrews 12, 1 and 2. Yes, resurrection living has to do with a new beginning, a new identity, newness of life. Paul reminds us in Colossians 3, if you then be risen with Christ from the first verse, seek those things which are above, where Christ sits at the right hand of the Father. Set your affections, your love, on things above and not on things on the earth. Well, I realize we are realizing more and more that what we have, a man's life does not consist in the abundance of things that he possesses. What we have cannot buy salvation. It has already been taken care of more than 2,000 years ago, when God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Come on, let's get to that place where we understand that life doesn't consist in the abundance of things that we possess. So seek those things which are above. Set your affections on things above, not on things on the earth. For we are dead, and our lives are hidden with Christ in God. Do you know him as your Savior and Lord? If you do not, this is a tremendous opportunity for you to surrender to his lordship. His lordship. The same man who you crucified, Peter said in one of the texts that I read earlier, the Father has made him both Lord and Christ. If we will confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So newness of life, the resurrection living must be transferred to newness of life. A walk must be different. Must. We are salt and we are light. We're here to make a difference for the glory of God. Yes, resurrection life has not only to do with a new beginning, a new identity, newness of life, but it has to do also with a living hope. a living hope. Peter says he has begotten us unto a living hope. 1 Peter 1 and verse 3. Because of his resurrection, because he's alive. This is about life, people. Life that will no longer, living that will no longer die, will no longer hold us. Jesus speaks in John the 5th chapter and the 24th verse. He says, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. He makes it clear in John chapter 10 and verse number 10. He says, the thief comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He says, but I am come that you would have life and have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Life in all its fullness, not just for time, but for all eternity. A living hope. Glory be to God. While the creation is groaning and travailing and they're awaiting their redemption, we too, that's right, those of us who know him as Savior and Lord, we too, we're realizing we're all in this thing together. We're all restricted. We're all hampered. We're all fit. We're all quarantined, all of us, to some extent. This is earth. So we await our redemption. What about you this morning? I want to let you know the spin-off comes there. A living hope. Romans chapter 8 from verse number 20 to verse number 28. Verse 28 reminds us, and we know that all things work together for the good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. This morning, are you called to? Yes, he's calling you now, but do you understand? Believer, do you understand what God has called you to do? Are you purposeful now in your living? I trust that you would become, because of the resurrection life flowing in you and through you. Remember, it is he who works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Get involved. Use the technology to glorify his name today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A living hope. Okay, let me give you two more and then we will close with it. It is not just a new beginning, a new identity, newness of life, a living hope, but also an active living faith. The resurrection life ought to bring about and transfer into us an active living faith. Notice what I said. You can have faith for the past and have faith for the future. Like Mary and Martha. Lord, if you had been here, but I know he shall rise again in the resurrection. What about our present faith? Active living. I'm going to say to you, it comes alive and it stays alive when we would seek God. It stays alive when we would get into the Word of God. Stop talking about the past. And if it can't help you to propel you to do something greater in the future, well, then the past is a place not of residence. The past is a place of reference. Get it there and move on. Glory to God. Active living faith. Romans 1:17. The just shall live by faith. Galatians 3:11. The just shall live by faith. Hebrews 10:38. The just shall live by faith. We must live by faith. Every believer, and those of you who do not know him as Savior and Lord, I want to give you the opportunity to trust him. So you can come into an agreement with him. You can, not an agreement now. It has already been taken place. But a relationship and fellowship with him. Glory be to God. 1 John 5:4. Whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. And finally, it is not resurrection life and living. The outworking of it has to do with a new beginning, a new identity, newness of life, a living hope, an active living faith, and a fearless, finally, a fearless assurance. Notice what I said there. A fearless assurance. God, 2 Timothy 1:7, has not given to us the spirit of fear when you know him as Savior and Lord, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Isaiah reminds us in Isaiah 41:10, fear thou not, for I am with you. Be not afraid, I am your God. Be not dismayed, I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. A fearless assurance. Romans 8:35 to 39, and I want you to really get that. I'm going to repeat it again. Romans 8:35 to 39. You need to take some time out and meditate on that, because, in fact, the whole of Romans chapter 8, but 35 to 39 in this time, where Paul says, nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors. What shall separate us from the love of God? Shall persecution and famine? It's right there. I'm not going to go into it all, but you're going to read it there in the scriptures. Distress, peril, viruses. Oh no, nay, in all these things, the COVID-19, nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Glory be to God. We will conquer this for the glory of God. Here's an opportunity now to be strong in faith. Hallelujah. Then he went on to say in verse 39, I want to get that. I want to read that. Hallelujah. Romans 8 in verse 39. Well, let me take it up from verse 38. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, any other disease, any other virus, whatever it may be, whatever the name is, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Because God hath highly exalted him and given unto him a name which is above every name. Yes, there is a name that is above COVID-19. That's the name of Jesus. And you can declare it because it has been made available for us. That at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow, of things in heaven, and things in the earth, and things under the earth. And every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Will you do that now? Will you do that now? We're talking resurrection life. The one who was crucified more than 2,000 years ago is Lord and Christ, because he rose again the third day from the dead. Death couldn't keep him down, and death will not be able to keep us down. Glory be to God. The Bible makes it abundantly clear, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. The question is this morning, do you know him? Do you know him as your Savior and Lord? Have you ever confessed him? I want to give you the opportunity to do that now. Right in the confines of your home, maybe in Coover and Cora, wherever you are quarantined, secluded, and maybe you're thinking nobody cares, there's someone who cares. His name is Jesus. You're hospitalized, you're sick, dying. Is there any hope? Yes, I spoke to you of a living hope that comes through Jesus Christ. Is there any healing? Yes, he's the resurrection and the life. Would you trust him this morning? Pray this prayer with us, please. And I believe that there are many persons praying. You've seen the numbers on the screen there. You're free to call. But pray. Let's pray together. You could talk to him. Let's pray together. I'm here to lead you, to help you. Oh, God, I thank you for sending Jesus, who paid the price for my sins. He died, was buried, but he rose again to set me free and to make me your child. Forgive me now of all my sins. Wash me in your precious blood. Come into my life now and save me. I confess you as my Savior and as my Lord, and I believe, Jesus, you are alive and alive forevermore. So thank you for writing my name in your book of life on this Resurrection Sunday. Thank you for life. Thank you for eternal life. Amen. Father, thank you today for those who have prayed that prayer. Thank you for the release and the freedom that you have given to them. You've given to us in the name of Jesus the Christ. Thank you for resurrection life, oh God, flowing through our being. Thank you for the power that is available to heal every sickness and every disease in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus. We call that name. That's right. Call that name, Jesus. There's healing in that name. We call that name, Jesus. There is deliverance in that name. We call that name, Jesus. There is satisfaction in that name. We call the name Jesus. There is security in that name. We call the name Jesus. There is safety in that name. We call the name Jesus. There is salvation, salvation, salvation in that name. We bless you, Father, for ministering today by the power of your Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. Blessed be his glorious name. As I mentioned earlier, we want to be having communion on this resurrection morning. Yes, where we remember his resurrection. He is alive and alive indeed. You're born again. I want you to put yourself together. And you should have done that. We're looking at 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Get a piece of bread. If you do not have bread, piece of biscuit, cracker. Yes. Get some grape juice. If you don't have it, get it close as you can to the grape juice, the wine. We want to stay away from the alcoholic wine this morning, please. Because we're looking at soberness, see? We want to make sure we do the thing right. Now, Pastor, you may be saying, I'm not a member of your church, and am I eligible? Here's what I want to say. Here's a qualification. You got to have a BA, meaning that you must be born again. Born again. And when I say born again, what am I talking about? Pastor, I'm baptized. Wait a minute. I'm born of the water and of the Spirit. The water symbolizes the word. He that believeth and is baptized. So it's on hearing the word. You understand there must be a new beginning. There must be a new identity. There must be newness of life. So you have received him. You've confessed him as your Savior and Lord. So you received him into your life. And then you further followed him in water baptism. Yeah. If you've done so, this is what qualifies you to partake of. As far as I'm aware of, from Scripture, except the thief on the cross cried out, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. But I don't remember him taking communion there. But you're sober-minded. You understand what you're about. You followed him in water baptism. And you're seeking to live a life pleasing to him. Then partake. Other than that, don't make a mockery of things. Because I want to read the scriptures to you now. Yeah? 1 Corinthians 11 chapter. Before we bless the bread and the wine. 1 Corinthians 11 chapter. I'm reading now from verse number 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup. And when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. It's not in remembrance of the church, nor the pastor. It is in remembrance of Jesus, the resurrected Christ, the one who ascended to the Father and is at the right hand of his Father even now. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes. Well, that's something in itself. That's a message in itself. Notice, the Lord's death. So he died. He was buried. He rose again. And he's coming again. He's coming for a prepared people. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, in the case of a woman, herself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. Wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement or the blows that we should have gotten and the debt we should have gotten for our sins, he took it. And with his stripes, we are healed. The stripes that he bore, the stripes that he received. For he that eateth and drinketh damnation, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Wherefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, tarry one for another. So I am going to wait for you a couple, 30 seconds or so. Get the bread, get the wine. Okay, I believe by now you would have gotten it, and we want now to bless the emblems and then we will partake. Let's pray. Our Father, we thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your grace and for sending Jesus, who paid the price for our sins, our sicknesses, and our debt. And your word declares every time we do communion, we do show the Lord's debt until he comes. We bless the bread and we bless the wine. These are emblems, the bread speaking of the body, symbolizing the fact that he paid the price, wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. And with his stripes, we are healed. The wine symbolizing the blood that was shed for every sin. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that is able to purge our consciences from dead works to serve the living and true God. We bless these emblems today. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen and amen. Well, let's eat together, please. Let's eat together. And then in the same manner, he took the cup. Haven't given thanks, so we've given thanks already. Let's drink together. Praise God. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We receive the benefits and the blessings of this communion today. Yes, your healing, your deliverance, your strength from the crown of our heads to the soles of our feet. Ah, Lord, we receive grace to live from day to day, to live moment by moment. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you, Lord, for ministering in every area of our lives, spirit, soul, and body, as we continue to walk by faith and live by faith and stand by faith and worship you. Hallelujah. For you are great and greatly to be praised. Thank you. Father, now we lift up our people, Trinidad and Tobago. We lift up those who are in the front line for our good. Continue to strengthen them and their families. Bless the leaders of our land. Oh God, thank you for making us great because of your goodness towards us. Thank you for keeping us and watching over us. I now commit everyone into your hands. Thank you for your church. You are building your church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We bless you and praise you this morning, Father. We worship you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Yes, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Well, bless the Lord. I want to say to all of us this morning, we're not going under because Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. And that's the name that I want you to use, please. There's power in that name. Remember, we're on Tuesday morning, Sky 99.5 on 5 a.m. The Tuesday evening at 6:30, we continue our Bible study. We are looking forward for tremendous times in the presence of the Lord. Get into the Word of God. Search the Scriptures. You can never go wrong. Spend more quality time in prayer with God. Your life will never be the same again. God bless you. Have a great day and a great week. Again, happy resurrection. Let life flow through you as never before. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for that very timely word. If you need prayer and counseling, you can contact us at 642-5950, 491-2471, and 772-7123. Once again, we want to say thank you for connecting with us. We trust that you have a safe and enjoyable week. Be blessed.
Show me your face. Fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you right now. I can't escape being afraid. Fill me with you.